What is Google News?
Well, this is Google News.
And this is Google News.
The definition is not so important, but if you still insist, check the link on the description below. But in simple, Google News is a news aggregator, meaning they collect news from hundreds of thousands of sources from around the world and present it to you in one single app and its website. Namaste Earthlings, this is Abhishek and welcome to another episode of The App Affair. If you like what I bring to you, don't forget to click on the subscribe button and the bell icon for all future notifications. Now today we're going to take a look at why Google News is the only news app you're going to need and how you can personalize it in a way that suits your interests best. First of all, it comes built into your phone, and even if it's not there, you'll at least find the old Play Newsstand pre-installed. So there are two ways of dealing with this. First, you open the old Newsstand app and it'll take you to Google Play so that you can update it there. Or you can go to Google Play directly and update the old Newsstand app. Once we are in the app, your icon at the top right corner will let you into the settings section where you can start arranging the app in a way you would like it to function. You can decide on the volume of notifications you would like to receive. And then there's the temperature settings for the weather. The app has four sections: For You, Headlines, Favorites, and Newsstand. In the For You section, the Google News AI tries to bring you stories based on your activities in the app. It brings you news that it thinks you would be interested in, or topics you may have searched and saved while in the app. The more you use it, the more accurate its predictions get. In the headlines section, you can find news about what's latest: India, world, business, entertainment, sports, science, health, and my favorite, technology. The newsstand section lets you choose stories from a wide variety of topics and sources. You can even save them as your favorites. Now to the favorites section. Here you will find the list of all the topics and news sources you have saved. And adding topics as your favorite is fairly simple. All you have to do is tap on the plus icon, enter the topic you're interested in, and tap on the star button. And the topic will appear on your favorite screen just like that. There's an interesting feature here. Let's say there's a story you like, and if you click on view full coverage, you'll be able to see what other sources are saying about the same story. You can even see how this story is being played out on Twitter. You can easily share stories via WhatsApp, Facebook, SMS, email, etc. You can save stories to read later and find all these stories in the favorites section under saved stories. You can also add different locations to stay updated with what's happening in those places. Now normally you would see stories in a carousel format, but there's a mini cards option in your settings, and if you use that, all the stories will appear with individual thumbnails rather than the collective carousels. Now there's no doubt that there are a lot of other news apps to choose from, since almost all news outlets around the world have their own apps. One very popular news app in India that I can think of is InShots, that brings you news stories in only 60 words. While I have used it for a long time now, I feel that there are way too many ads in it. And even though companies need ad revenues in order to survive, I thought presenting too many ads and making them look like news articles instead of ads was not too smart on their part. Also, I thought the app was comparatively slower. Anyway, those were just my thoughts. I hope you liked this video. Once again, please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. You've been watching Second Impression, and I'll see you in the next one.